message is here.
Thinking of a master plan. This ain't nothing but sweat inside my hands. So I dig into my pocket, all my money spent. So I get deeper, but still coming up with lint. So I start my mission, leave my residence. Thinking how I could get some dead presidents. I need money. I used to be a stick-up kid. So I think of all the devious things I did. I used to roll up, this is a hole up. Ain't nothing funny, stop smiling. You still know nothing move but the money. But now I learn to earn cause I'm righteous. I feel great, so maybe I might just search
God,
for
King
a 9-5. If I strive, then maybe I stay alive. So I walk up the street, whistling this, feeling out of place, cause man, do I miss.
A you know, there's a lot of people who deserve Grammys who never won a Grammy. This, I'm not impressed with their so-called Grammy winners. Because they're paid pundits. They're paid plants. Very few of them really earned it. If you know, you know. This business is a joke for clout. When the labels and the ones at the top are the ones who make the money. I would suggest that you watch a lot of documentaries from the greats, the truly greats. You young people, if you're talking about anybody from like the last 10, 20 years, you don't know fucking great. I'm talking about go back to the people. Yeah, go back to your history. The people who opened the doors for those who did this now. Like your Chuck Berry's and your why come I can't think of his name? You know who I'm talking about. You know, the one before Prince. You know, and check out your Dorothy Dandridge's and your brothers, you know, your Calloways and all those, and Josephine Baker's, and check out their lives. Watch documentaries. Watch some of those black and white documentaries on YouTube about the really famous people, your Nina Simone's and Billie Holiday's, and how great they were, but how they weren't recognized. And you're looking at people now and wondering what's happening the way it is, because the way it is now is the way it's always been. The business is not Hollywood. Hollywood and the industry is not set up for you to win. So actually, I didn't blow my career. My career is thriving. And all these people's careers are not. They're having to do what they do, and they're having to take the shot because they're being paid. And they have stock in it. Find the lie. People just don't drop dead. Like all those soldiers at Fort Bragg. Yeah. Somebody thinks that the soldiers, the U.S. military, are the new slaves. They done used up all the rest of you. They done used up the civilians. They done used up, you know, those of you, the drug addicts and the hustlers and the pimps. And, you know, they done used up the preachers. You know, they done used up everybody. And now they're trying to use up the only ones who are standing to defend them. The soldiers. And they feel like these men and women who are very triggered right now, incredibly triggered, they know something's going on, and they know that, you know, this country is really not for them, because they've heard the stories of the veterans who are still fighting for their benefits, and they got dropped Agent Orange on them. I mean, we're talking about Vietnam, and like my husband, you know, first Saudi war, like, you know, many of the illnesses our soldiers have gotten, we've gotten from our own countries. The chemical warfare of our own country. And I say our country because, God damn it, one more white person got one more time to come up in my face and talk about go back. And I'm a bust you in your ass. How dare you? We were here before you. Bitch, you better know who you come to when you talk to me. You think I'm scared of you? You really should be scared of me. You really should. You really, really should. So I would suggest don't even come to me. At all. Just go to the people who you think, you know, you can beat down with a slave. Because I'm from that bloodline. We will kick your ass. I didn't buy a Glock for table adornments or book rest. I didn't go to class. I didn't pay for a class just to not be able to not know how to use it. And it's not loaded with gold dots. Not defenders. Gold dots. If you really know what you know, ask yourself, what's the difference between gold dots and defenders? Ooh, my tribe. They just, I mean, it's like living in Little Belize. They just be circling around. That's their way of saying, you want to come here and mess with her? We don't think so. I have a cartel too. They're really about the queen. By the way, I want my Billy. A Billy. It's going to take a Billy. It's going to take a Billy. Well, you know, for the whole team. You know, I just want you to be fair with me. You owe me. Pay up. Not in spades and in real money. Or you either just don't ask me for anything. Some of y'all are still expecting a prize when you haven't seeded into nothing. That's not how it works. Anyway, that's all I had to say. I'm home.
2018.
Where's my channel? I slipped on because every now and then I still do like to live, but yeah. I mean, 97.3 from here to the coast. Coast 97.3, Boost 97.3. I'm not a church girl, by the way. I'm not, you know. And it's not like I'm pushing church on people either. I'm not. Please don't think that. I'm pushing you to think and make sense of your spirituality. Make sense of your spirit and your spirituality, because you have been lied to and the math is all there. If you're still stuck on stupid, then you're going to get a stupid song. No, nothing from nothing equals nothing. And if you think Jesus is going to come from a cloud, well, you must be looking for him to come through the mushroom cloud. Jesus or Abigail is not going to save you when these countries decide to nuke the fuck out of us, or we decide to nuke, or, you know, karma's karma. So you just better get right with your life. Get right with yourself. You're talking about getting right with God. Clearly, some of you, number one, don't know who God is. Number two, are you right with your life? Are you really? Because you don't act like it. What are you hiding? Why are you mad that I'm winning? I deserve to win. I really do. So you need to ask yourself, why are you mad that I'm actually winning and doing good and really about that life of wanting to leave a better world for children and for those who come behind me instead of just fronting? I didn't suck off to get to the top. I didn't suck off when I was on my last penny. I didn't suck off, you know, when I was becoming homeless. I didn't suck off with any of that. Before I was going to do that, I would have rather killed myself. And I tried, and it didn't happen. So clearly, I was meant to make it. And not only did I make it, I am now an example to those who realize you don't have to kiss ass. You don't have to fuck your boss. You don't have to play a role. And a rapey person is a rapey person, whether you're male or female. Don't get I tell you, these organizations, these alphabet people, they're not about the people. They're about their pockets. So don't come to me with your alphabet agendas. Because trust me, I am designed and programmed to slay you completely. And I will. You don't control my money. But you know what I control? I don't control nothing. I don't control nothing. I'm not going to say that. I don't control nothing. But I do have a vibe for the military. Maybe I am the military's Deanna Troy. If I am, well, let's just say, if you think the military is going to be your new slaves, you haven't seen revolution yet. Good luck with that. Okay. Class dismissed. Sister daughter, how do I do this? I am fucking 66 years old. How am I looking better than some of these hoes in their 20s? Definitely their 30s. I look better than all the Kardashians. Okay, you how is she saying that? No, bitch, I do, because all that shit is with plastic surgery and they still falling the fuck apart. I am 66 years old with no plastic surgery. Look at all the, even the black women who went to get plastic surgery and it's still, and their shit's falling apart. But you mad at, what am I got to be? Why would I be jealous of them? I am 66 and looking gorgeous. I'm amazed at myself. Once I die, because I might leave. No, my van. I know. I've had this hair grid. I'm had a grid enough. I'm going to, by next month, I'm going to dye it. You know, I really look super young. But the fact that I'm 66 years old, how do you look at 60? How do you look at 40? How do you look at 30? People are like, well, you know you old. No, you old. Don't put your shit on me. That's you. Why you mad? You ain't me. Why you mad? People always want to say what's happening to them is happening to you. It's like, maybe not. Our lives are clearly different. Look at me and look at you. Look at me and look at you. Look at me. That Blackpink song does hit hard, though, doesn't it? Shout out to BTS, my Asian invasion. They did their thing, too. It was an epic weekend. This past weekend. It's just amazing. Amazing. Life is amazing. It's amazing. It's amusing and it's amazing. That's it. Are you liking my vlogs? Are you looking at the ones where the divine feminine is feeling like this and divine masculine and divine feminine? You know what? You just need to, like, you know, you're not, you just need to, you have a prize coming to you, but you're not stepping. I'm doing exactly what I need to be doing. How about that? How about if you want to know what's happening to me, how about you stop reading these cards or you stop reading what you think and you ask me? I am absolutely accessible to the right person. The person who you're talking about knows that and actually talks to me. But, you know, y'all on this fantasy shit and those who are being paid to do the lie. And then some of you, I know you're trying to figure it out. So I get where you're coming from. And Mama Mystic Mohawk, I listen to you. Because from day one, you've been straight up honest, especially that one time when you talked about the boy. I'm trying, Mama. But you and I both know you raised me to take care of me first. Because other people's addictions are not mine to have. I'm not going to take on some shit that ain't mine. I've never been addicted, maybe other than coffee. I've seen addictions. I've seen alcoholism. I've dated people that I didn't know. They were on coke, you know, or maybe, I don't know. But all I know is that it's like, I'm not doing that. You can't help that. Those people, you need to like throw them straight to rehab or whatever. You can't do nothing but save yourself. When you're coming to me, you got to be off that shit, because I don't do fiends. I might do a little bit of weed, but I don't do powder, and I don't like going to the doctors because I don't like needles. So anything remotely dealing with a needle, get the fuck out of my complete life, because you are a hardcore fiend. And like, no, there's no overlooking that. Once I see that, I can't unsee it. I don't have to be that to know what that, you know, I've been close enough to it to know, like, that's not my life and not going to be. Especially now. That's like taking 10 steps back. Who does that in the right mind if you're trying to evolve? Who goes back into the shit that you come up out of? You understand the math? Sun is shining bright. It is. I'm glowing. How y'all doing? Are you glowing? Are you growing? Are you knowing? Are you sowing good seeds? If you're saying be kind, are you really being kind? Or are you lying? Now, the police was just up here the other day. I don't know if somebody got hurt or died. I don't know, but you know what? I'm not going to be. You know, people have their own modalities on how they're getting through this stuff. So I'm not going to argue, because you know what? At the end of the day, my community may have my little community may have some issues and stuff like that, but at least it's familiar. Family is family by actions, clearly not by blood. That's been proven. Anyway.